400 years ago, the birth pangs of a great new nation began when a group of pilgrims, in defiance of the spiritual oppression of their native country, risked everything and crossed the vast Atlantic Ocean so they could be free to live as they believed. We live in that great nation today. Another historical event took place after a 400-year span. God delivered the nation of Israel out of Egypt, where they had suffered under oppression, slavery, and cruelty for 400 years. Through a series of difficult challenges, God delivered them from horrible bondage and led them out of Egypt and on to a journey towards the Promised Land. But the morning after their escape, the Egyptians woke up to a living nightmare. Every Egyptian household found their firstborn sons had been slain in the night, and they were enraged. In their fury, Pharaoh and an army of soldiers raced after the Israelites in their golden chariots. The Israelites feared they had met their doom. On the edge of the Red Sea, they had nowhere to turn, and they cried out to God. At the last hour, God delivered them by miraculously parting the Red Sea, and they walked across on dry land safely to freedom. The Egyptians chased after them into the Red Sea. But just as the last man, woman, and child had crossed to the other side, the waters of the Red Sea returned to its normal state, and the Egyptian army and all their horses were drowned. In a time of crisis, God made a way. We are living in a time when we need to see a supernatural Red Sea parting. A parting of the way to restore us back to the beliefs and values that our founding fathers consecrated this nation to be before God, declaring truth, freedom, liberty, and justice for us all. And indeed, God has made a way. We are reminded of that this Christmas season, a miracle birth. God brought forth a Savior, a Redeemer, a Deliverer, and His name is Jesus, and He is the Son of God. He is the one that Isaiah had prophesied about hundreds of years prior. A Christ child, a Prince of Peace, a King, would be born of a virgin young mother who said yes to God. During these tumultuous times in our nation, my Christmas prayer is for you, that you will find your yes. Yes to truth, righteousness, freedom, liberty, and justice. It may mean surrender of power, greed, adultery, addiction, perversion, or to the killing of innocent babes. For believers, it may mean coming out of complacency. Mary said yes, not knowing what was ahead. And with the birth of Jesus, her yes brought us hope and deliverance. Jesus is the supernatural way that God has provided for us, and the government shall be upon His shoulder. Our yes brings not only life everlasting, but grace, peace, hope, love, and triumph in a world that is unpredictable and filled with darkness. This Christmas season, we are reminded that the baby Jesus brought light into the world, and He became the Redeemer for all mankind. He is the miracle that brings freedom to us all. As you celebrate this Christmas, consider your yes and discover the true meaning of Christmas. Our Deliverer, God in the flesh, was born on Christmas Day. God indeed has made a way. Thank you for watching, and may God bring blessings to you and your loved ones this Christmas season and in the coming new year.